Hey, what's going on, my friends? Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Victor, and today I'm going to share with you five signs that you are not only an empath, not only abnormally sensitive and perceptive, but a psychic empath, someone with truly special intuitive powers and talents that can be used for your own gain, for your own forward progress in life, very effectively and efficiently, but even more so for the good of other people. A lot of people I find, a lot of empathic, sensitive people are not yet comfortable with their newer level of sensitivity and have yet to discover what it actually is, which is psychic powers, in a sense, without sounding too like witchy. It's true. Your sensitivity, once honed in, once you learn to roll with it, in a sense, the best way I could put it, once you really come to understand it, you'll see. It's just like, it's a huge, huge blessing. And it's just a new talent sort of being born within you. So my intention for this video is to help you empathic people start seeing your sensitivity in a new way. And once you can become aware in the ways in which it's helping you and assisting you, you can start allowing your psychic abilities to really blossom, because they will deepen. There's a beginning of, oh wow, this can happen within my consciousness now. But once you start to become aware that that's happening and start to kind of focus on it and roll with it, it will expand and deepen. And before you know it, you're extremely psychic, and it just kind of sneaks up on you. That's my goal for those of you watching who aren't yet aware of the power and talent they possess. Number one is you see, hear, and or feel the following. Do you see lights, orbs, flashes of light that sort of zoom by your vision that you know isn't just like it's not a laser pointer pen, it's just like a flash of light? Do you ever see the energy fields around people, auras as they call them? That's because you have this clairvoyant type of vision. You're not crazy and your eyes aren't going bad. It's just you're seeing what for most people is the unseen. Do you hear noises, high pitches, ringing? A lot of you, it's not tinnitus. It's just you can, in an audible way, hear the hum, the frequencies, the vibrations of activity in your surrounding environment, because we live in a vibrational reality. Physical reality is not what it really appears to be. It's not as solid as it looks and feels. It's a vibrational manifestation, and it's our perception that causes it to seem solid. And some of you psychic empaths out there, can literally hear the vibrations of the reality you're in. Or do you feel other people's energies, other people's emotions, other people's moods? Do you feel your own energy, your own impressions from the stimuli of life? We are all different, and our psychic abilities will manifest very differently for each individual, but most psychic empaths will fall under one or more of these categories of see, hear, and feel. Number two, have you had an experience that you wouldn't really feel comfortable sharing in front of most people? Kind of an unusual, maybe mystical, paranormal type of experience. I'll give an example. When I was in 11th or 12th grade, I can't recall, I was in high school, obviously, and I had woken up, or so I thought, out of a dream, and I went through what people would call sleep paralysis, where I woke up and I felt the presence. It was this uncanny knowing and just like sick sense of a presence of kind of a ill-intentioned being sitting on my back, holding me down. And I tried to scream, and I couldn't scream. And I knew I was like lucid, I was awake. And eventually I fought it off. And it was so mind-blowing to me. In 11th or 12th grade, whatever, I was 17, 18 years old, I shot out of bed and I ran into mommy and daddy's room. I said, Mom, you know, something happened. Right? That's crazy. No, I tried to tell my high school friends later that day and they're like, I don't know, were you high, Vic? What's the deal, bro? It was real, man. And I've had that experience many times. But it's one of those things that doesn't really, I couldn't find answers from the doctors or the counselors or books, but it was a very real experience. And that's just one little teeny way this can manifest, okay? So if you had your own paranormal, mystical type of experiences that you probably wouldn't choose to bring up around the dinner table or at the family reunion or at the water cooler at work. Number three, do you feel a deep empathy and compassion for Earth and its people and want to help from a very deep and organic and natural place, a true longing, but don't know how? I'll never forget when I was going through this phase of my life or development when I knew I wanted something deeper and I wanted to help, but I didn't know how. I was sitting at doing like some stretching or yoga at the gym I was attending at the time, and there's this person that kind of walked by and they were very overweight, very obese. And at that time I was a personal fitness trainer. I'd help people lose 10 pounds for a wedding, you know, try to like, you know, decrease the pain in their joints. Somewhat, in a sense, superficial goals, not as deep as I really felt called to help people. And as this really overweight person walked by, I felt this feeling of like, that's what I want to do. I want that person. I want to help them see just who they really are underneath the manifestation of some of their maybe bad habits. I wanted to help them transform completely, totally, on all levels, beyond just the 10 pounds to fit in the wedding dress. I wanted to help this person discover who they are. And as I was thinking about all this, I just felt this feeling in my chest and in my heart, like almost like getting choked up. I felt like, just like, yes, this is it. That wasn't it. I don't do that. But that was me getting closer and guiding myself to the line of work I'm in now, which is to help people in a very deep and just profound and transformative way. But the psychic empathic person didn't come here just to win the lottery and be like a wizard and sort of just have fun with themselves. No, they came to use those gifts for the purpose of helping and healing and transforming and raising up other people. And when you find out the way you came to express your own psychic talents, they will deepen, they will expand, and you will become you will just step out of the way, and the service will just kind of take over, and it's a beautiful, beautiful thing. Number four, most empathic people are psychic, and a lot of them don't have it. Some of them don't have it in a very obvious way, like how I've described, but you are still psychic big time if you are what's known as claircognizant. It's one of the four clairs, one of the four ways that your psychic abilities can be manifested. And what that means is a knowing. Do you ever know something without knowing why you know it? That's your claircognizance. Long time ago, I saw this psychic named Kevin, real good, real extremely good psychic. And he put it to me real frank. He said, Victor, you're really intuitive and claircognizant. He said, if you think someone's a butthead, they are a butthead. That was his words, not mine. He said, you need to trust that. And when he said that to me, it really clicked. And I was like, you know what? I think you're right, Kevin. I've always doubted my intuition. I've always kind of questioned it because I didn't know where it came from. It didn't make sense to my logical mind. But once I started kind of like just assuming my intuition, my claircognizance was accurate and acting from that perspective, I was able to really get along well in my life. I found it to be very, very helpful in making decisions without needing to be overly informed and overanalyzing. I just would know stuff and then act as if I really was accurate, and it's always been accurate. So if that's you, I can't tell you how many people I've coached or talked to that are super psychic, super claircognizant, but don't trust it because they don't know why. It doesn't make sense. Their family thinks they're they're being sloppy with life, or they're misinformed because they can't explain to them why they're making some of these choices. I'm here to be like Kevin and tell you, if you think someone's a butthead, they are a butthead. If you feel a guidance to do something and don't know why, trust it. That's coming from a much deeper and wiser place than the limitations of your mind anyways. And I promise you, when you start really trusting and acting from even maybe perhaps your bold impressions and clear cognizant signs, your life will transform and blossom in ways you can't even fathom. Number five, your life is going through a lot of shifts, a lot of changes right now because it's time for you to remember who you are and be the person you came to be. And what I just said, if you're one of the psychic empathic people on the planet right now around 2019, then what I just said, I would assume struck a chord with you. Because you already knew this intuitively, because your claircognizant abilities, you already knew this, right? You knew deep down all of this stuff, all of these unusual life experiences, are in fact happening for a reason. It's because you came to help, you came to explore your psychic potential, and you came to share it, your talent, yourself, your gifts, your healings with the world. And once you come into alignment with your preferred way of doing that, then your life is going to become awesome. And your psychic senses will become a lot more turned on and noticeable. This happened to me when I started coaching people online. I started my YouTube channel and I was doing my thing and that felt really good. And I started to surprise myself with the fact that I can kind of channel in my videos. And that was sort of a new ability because I was starting to express it out there for the purpose of helping people. But what really was noticeable to me is when I started coaching people. I'd work with people from all over the world, all walks of life, older people, younger people, all different types of cool light worker type of people. And when I started working with them on the phone, I would just call them up. I started to have different psychic abilities kind of turn on. For example, I'll give kind of a different example. Whenever somebody was touching upon or talking about something that was like a past life issue, I know that sounds weird, I could feel it. I could feel this feeling in my chest that I knew that this person was like dabbling with something very, very deep within themselves. And then I kind of knew, okay, I really need to be kind of cautious and tread carefully in the way I help this person uncover what that is. Even more so when someone would talk about something that they were unaware of yet, but it was their life purpose. And they were like, yeah, I really like painting. My body would just light up with these feelings of like, yes, 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 yes. Encourage this person to do exactly that. That's their thing. So your psychic abilities will again blossom when you start really trying to put yourself out there, pushing through your own resistance and blocks and perhaps the resistance of other people and just helping in whatever way you can and know how to. Your abilities will blossom and become way more noticeable to the point where you don't need a video like this to tell you what you already know about yourself. But in the meantime, it is my intention for this video to maybe spark something within you and encourage you to follow that intuition of yours and watch it blossom, because it will help yourself, it will help other people, and it will help the collective, the planet, which is what we're all here to do right now at this very special and charged time in human history. So thank you, my friend, for watching. I wish you well, my fellow psychic empathic person, you. Have an amazing day. If you are new to my channel, then maybe you don't know, I do offer everyone a free guided meditation. It's actually designed to help you come into more of a conscious alignment with your always present connection with your higher self and your higher consciousness. You're always connected. We all are, but not everyone really knows it. Just like a lot of people watching this video don't know they're super psychic. This meditation will help you become aware of your depth of connectedness. It's totally free. It's a channel meditation. Check it out down below at the top of the description box, or I always post the comment at the top as well, a pinned comment. You can see it there as well. With that said, I'm gonna bounce. I gotta get to the beach. My boy Aaron, he's probably chilling back there on the computer. You guys have an amazing day. Talk to you soon. Much love. Peace.